Shubhodaya. Welcome all. The yoga, Ashtanga yoga, according to Patanjali. Patanjali, Ashtanga yoga starts with Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, Iti Ashtango. Yogango. It's a yoga's eight limbs. Eight limbs of yoga are starting from Yama and Niyama. Yama and Niyama are the rules and regulations which are needed to be followed if you want to build up a castle of eight-story building. If the foundation itself is weak and wrong, if we are building the castle on a wrong footing, entire building will collapse. You can't expect the building to sustain, and you can't build up the one above the other. For that, your foundation should be strong and on a firm footing it should be. And Yama is talking about, before we start our yoga practice, we should have a clear vision. I should do the yoga practice not only for myself, how I can enrich the community. I have to add value to the community. How my presence, I have come to this world, how my presence be of use for others. That is Yama. First thing, I should be clear. When I am doing yoga, my life should be of use for others. How I can add value. And Niyama talks about, before you add value to others, you should have add value to yourself. I am not adding value, any value to myself, and without adding myself, without adding value to myself, without me doing practice, how can I add value to others? You have to practice. You have to observe some disciplines. They are called as niyama. Niyamas are rules I need to observe unto myself so that my practice, my presence, my life is of use for others. That is the starting point of yoga. And Niyama, Patanjali talks about five number, śhaucha, santosha, tapas. Last two classes I touched upon tapas, and this class also I will touch upon tapas. Tapa is difficulties. And we have to go through the hardship and endure the difficulties. Difficult patches of our life comes. Every the hot season followed by a cold season. Every spring and winter comes again and again. Good time and bad time comes. And every good time, when it is having a good time, I should remember God time, bad time is round the corner. When I am going through the tough time, I should always remember good time is round the corner. And ability to endure the tough time. Now around the world, everyone, all the countries are going through the tough time. Endure without blaming and complaining because of that person, because of this person. Endure, and everything, there is a, if I start blaming, no progress happens, no corrective action happens. And tapas means ability to endure the difficulties, that is called as tapas. And another meaning of tapas, persistence, perseverance and patience is called as tapas. The persistence and sustained effort. My sadhana is a sustained effort. I can't expect a miracle overnight. It is a sustained, years together I have to toil, work. It's a persistence and perseverance, not giving up. Many opportunities are there to give up. Today, for example, Melbourne is a very cold day. It's an opportunity for me to go under the blanket. Today is Mother's Day. It's an opportunity to skip yoga and relish on bed coffee. Many temptations comes for us not to practice, and persistence, perseverance, and while doing the sadhana, we can't expect the immediate outcome. Patience is required. Sustained effort. When I am doing the sadhana, and it is very tough. I have to get up early and I have to read books. I have to contemplate. I have to sit in posture. I have to do asana. I have to do pranayama. I have to do the observe silence. And I have to observe self-discipline. Initially, it sounds to be very difficult. And in Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna says, good never will come without hardship. And yadagre viṣham eva pariṇāme amṛitopamam tat sukhaṁ sāttvikaṁ proktam ātma-buddhi-prasāda-jam. If you want something good, something noble, auspicious in your life, you have to initially, it sound to be like a poison. If a small child, it's first time, if you want to send the child to the kindergarten, child will be crying and parents will be crying. Oh, I am sending my child to the child care for the first time, and child will be, it's very reluctantly going to the school. After few days, it starts enjoying the company of friends and new education, new learning, lot of fun. And after third, it's a few days, child will be asking the parents, I want to go to school. Why am I not going? And initially, it's tough sadhana, but when you get into this one, without asking, if there may be any other opportunities are there, you don't want that one. You want to do practice. And it says that is sattvika, that is tapas. Initially it is tough, but the result is something great. And if the rajasic tapas, it's a viṣhayendriya-sanyogād, yet agre amṛitopamam pariṇāme viṣhamiva tat sukhaṁ rājasaṁ smṛitam. And so much of fun, so much of entertainment. So many friends I have, and every night is a party, and initially it sound to be great fun. I'm having a great fun, and pariṇāme, and it becomes, ends with like a poison, ends with sickness, disease, and wear and tear. I become useless. And it says, initially it is tough. I had to do studies. I had to do master studies. PhD I am doing. Initially it is tough. I had to toil. But outcome is good. That is called as tapas. And Shri Krishna is talking about you have to do the tapas if you want to progress in your life, if you want to become a great value to the society, if you want to become a great value to yourself, you have to do tapas. And to do the tapas, you have to align your body, mind, your talking and mind together. And tapas in the physical body you have to do. When you are doing the tapas in the physical level, Sri Krishna says you should know how to respect elders. You should know how to respect the learned people. You should know how to respect your teacher. If you do not learn this one, how to respect your elders, your learned people, your teachers, then you are not doing tapas. And Sri Krishna says, deva-dwija-guru-prājña, pūjanaṁ, śhaucham, ārjavam, brahmacharya, ahinsā, śhārīraṁ, tapa, uchyate. And it's, if you want to do the tapas, you should learn to have humility and respect. respect the elders, respect the learned people, respect your teacher with humility. Approach the teacher with humility, not out of arrogance. These are the tapas in the physical level Sri Krishna is talking about. And if you want to go to the great height in your life, in the physical level, you have to do this one. In the talking level, what is the tapas? Sri Krishna is talking about anadvegakaram vakyam satyam priyam hitam chayate swadhyaya bhyasanam chaiva vangmayam tapa uchyate. In the talking level, control your talk and not to have loose talks and not out of emotion you are talking. And fit of anger, I am not talking out of fit of anger. Anudvegakaram, without any excitement. Anudvegakaram vakyam, when you talk, try to talk good things, sweet things and truth. And anudvegakaram vakyam, satyam priyam hitam chayate. Your talking should add value to others' life. If it's not adding value to others' life, don't talk. Not only this one, in the WhatsApp also, people just keep on forwarding messages. It is not adding any value to me. If I am sending something, it should add value for that person's life. It is not adding any value, it is just a time waster. It is wasting somebody's time. And some silly comments by somebody, some wild comments by somebody makes me very angry seeing that one. If it is agitating some person, makes that person becomes very boiling and disturbing that mind, why forward that one? And I should be, while forwarding also, if it is only adding value, then you send. If it is not adding value, then don't forward. That so much of social media garbage is coming, it takes lot of time to clean that one. Do not waste others' time. And anudvega karam vakyam satyam priyam hitam chayate swadhyaya bhyasanam chaiva. And next week I will be talking about swadhyaya, and you have to do the introspection. Read the scriptures, svadhyaya abhyasaram chaiva. Then the control over your talk is called as the tapas in the talking level. And in the thinking level, my talking, I may talk like a politician, very sweet talks at the time of election. Everyone will get free houses, everyone will get free toll-free roads and free education. Like, it's a beautiful talk, nice to hear. But thinking, are you thinking the same or only to win the votes and to impress people? And here, and manaprasada saumyatvam maunam atma vinigraha bhava samshuddhiritheta tapa manasa uchyate. Manaprasada, always calm mind, serene mind. And that serenity should be reflecting in your face, glow in the face, and smile on your face, as on your all the time. It's a manaprasada saumyatvam, very gentle person, saumyatvam, and not a loose talker, observing silence, and talking sparely, and whenever required, when most required, then only talk. Mana prasada saumyatvam maunam atma vinigraha. Control over your senses, control your mind, senses. Maunam atma vinigraha bhava samshuddhiritetat. And mind, why pure mind is required, helps in purifying our heart. If mind is polluted, it's loose talks and wrong actions. I'm defiling my own personality. If you want to have purity within, calm your mind. Your body, your actions, your talking and thinking should align together, should point, all three of them should point to the same direction. Like a compass needle always points to the north, and so is all three should align. There should not be, I am thinking something, talking something, doing something, and it won't bear any effort. And many people, they want to succeed in their life, but there is no, action is something else. I want to do something, but I am talking something, thinking something. Why these three are required? It helps in having the concentrated effort. Whatever I am doing, I should have a concentrated effort. And my efforts are very diluted, because thinking, talking and action are diluted. If I want to succeed in any endeavor, any area, if I want to succeed, I should put in a concentrated effort. To have a concentrated effort, tapas is a must. Without tapas, I can't have a concentrated effort. It will be a very diluted effort. With a diluted effort, my outcome also is diluted. Outcome. If I want to have a great outcome, and my value, I mentioned in the beginning, yoga's foundation, I have to add value. That is the prerequisite. I have to add value to the society. How to add? I should have a concentrated effort. To have a concentrated effort, tapas is a must. Tapas helps in concentrating, synthesizing, clarity in thinking improves, and my talking gets aligned with that one. My actions also will be great. And tapas is one of the prerequisites. Talks about again and again in by Lord Sri Krishna. It is mentioned in Yoga Sutra. It is mentioned in many other yoga texts. And tapas is the must for sadhana. Without tapas, we think tapas, I am not a renunciate, I am not a recluse, and to do tapas, modern day tapas is not possible. Tapas is a must. Whatever, whether you are a scientist, whether you are a business person, or whether you are in a householder, or in a community person, whatever area, whatever yoga, whether you want to teach yoga, whether you want to learn yoga, tapas is a must. Lie down on your